بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله سيدنا محمد رحمة المبارك على آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي القاسم يا رسول الله صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. طبعا all of us know about the story of Ka'b ibn Malik رضي الله عنه when Allah سبحانه وتعالى accepted his repentance, yes, على الثلاثة الذين خلفوا. The three people who were left behind, including Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. And of course, he stayed like 50 days until he received the glad tidings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. Yes? Ka'b ibn Malik actually, you know, he was very happy with that. And even it said to him, this is the best day of all of his life, when he recognized that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. Yes? He was very happy. And even he was going to donate all of his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as because of his happy, subhanAllah. طيب حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لله أفرح بتوبة عبد. If the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very happy because Allah accepted his repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more pleased when his servant is coming and says, oh Allah forgive my sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more pleased. Very happy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? When his servant's coming and says, oh Allah, forgive my sin. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more pleased for the repentance of the person than a person in the desert. And he has actually his mount, like a mule or whatever, in which he has his drink and his food over it. And the person, just he slept. And he told just, you know, the mount or the mule, it has his food and his drink. All of a sudden the person wake up. He couldn't find anything. He searched for the mount. Where is it? Where is my food? Where is my drink? He couldn't find any. We know that the person in the desert, if he couldn't find his food and his drink, would be crushed, yes? So he just searched for the mount, for his food and his drink. Everywhere he couldn't find anything. So the person returned it back and he slept again. And just, of course, he was disappointed. And he slept in the same place while waiting for the death. Waiting for the death. There is no clue for him. What should he do? Nothing. You know, the mount in which has his food and his drink, he lost it. That's why he returned back and says, I'm going to sleep and waiting for the death because there is nothing, you know, for me to do. All of a sudden, the person wake up and he found his mount and his drink and his food, subhanAllah, coming and waiting for him. So when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained the happiness of the person when he knows that the reason which brings him the life is already exist, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more pleased than this person, you know, subhanAllah, when he found his, you know, food and his drink. Imagine, أخي, subhanAllah, when you come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking the repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very happy than this person. So the meaning of the hadith, the person subhanAllah can feel the happiness once he repents to Allah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more happy when the person comes back to him. So that's why very important to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every time, whenever we commit the sin or even without committing the sin. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all our sins and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our repentance. Allahumma ameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.
Shut up!